My name is Nada Alachkar. I'm a transplant nephrologist at Johns Hopkins. I manage and care for patients with kidney transplant, and I do evaluation for patients to receive kidney transplantation. Patients with advanced chronic kidney disease, stage 4, stage 5, or end-stage kidney disease are candidate for kidney transplantation. So the major contraindication to receive kidney transplantations are usually acute or major cardiovascular diseases, recent event like MI or stroke or peripheral vascular disease that's active, or recent. Usually those, we have to wait until they become stable, so we don't transplant them at that point. The other major contraindication are cancers. Any acute or recent cancers is contraindication. There are only few cancers that we can transplant them shortly after they're treated for the cancer. Otherwise, we have to have free cancer waiting time. Acute or active infection is also major contraindication unless they are treated and clear the infection. There are a couple others, but they're usually, once they are cleared, we can put them on the waiting list and clear them for transplant. To manage the recipients before kidney transplantation, I do their evaluation initially. I see the patients in the clinic. I explain to them what they are going through and then what tests we need. And then I review their medical record. We order a few of the tests that to clear them for kidney transplantation. Then I review the results of those tests we ordered. And if there's any abnormality or any abnormal test, I follow up and we ask for more investigation. I sometimes contact their provider, local providers, and ask for further tests or further treatment or management. Once the patients are on the waiting list, I monitor those patients and we review their record on a regular basis and with the help of the waiting list team. To manage the recipients after the surgery, I see the patients after they receive the kidney transplantation in the hospital. We see them with the surgeons. We have a comprehensive team. We work together. We see the patients on a daily basis. We manage their medical problems along with the surgeons. And after they get discharged, when they are cleared from the surgical standpoint, the majority of the times they're transitioned to different nephrologists. I receive some of those patients and I continue to monitor those patients on a regular basis. I see them in the clinic. I manage their allograft function. We manage their immunosuppression. We manage if they have any infections, blood pressure, diabetes, their lab work. So mainly we are the main provider for those patients. And then we work with other providers to care for those patients. The quality of life of those patients who receive kidney transplant is excellent. They do very well. They live normal life. The majority of them, they do very well. They go back to work. They live normal life, as I said. Some people with major comorbidities, they do a little bit worse, but they still do much better than patients who stayed on dialysis or they did not receive kidney transplantation. So the prognosis of transplant patients is excellent. We look at survival of patients and kidney transplant about more than 90% on the majority of the centers. So it's really much better than patients who are staying on the waiting list. And 5 years and 10 years, we look at about 80% allograft survival and more than 50% allograft survival if they receive kidney transplant from deceased donor. And we look at about 15 years allograft survival from living donor. And the survival of the patients is much better than patients staying on dialysis or on the waiting list. Hopkins has a very well-organized, comprehensive kidney transplant center that has significant expertise in different fields of transplantation. We are one of the only few centers in the nation that have incompatible program. We transplant patients who are incompatible with their donors, and we do the paired exchange, and our program is one of the lead in this field. Adding to the expertise in the incompatible field, we have very large research program, and we have basic research lab in our transplant program that work on patients and also on mice in the transplant field. Adding to the organization of the transplant patients follow-up and caring for patients transplant makes Hopkins one of the lead transplant centers in the whole nation.